चैप्टर सेवन डेथ ऑफ हिज वाइफ डोरा। वन डे व्हेन डेविड रिटर्न्स होम फ्रॉम द फ्रंट डोर ही फाइंड्स दैट हिज आंट वाज टॉकिंग टू अ मैन एंड ही वाज गिविंग ट्रबल्स टू हर एंड ही वाज डिमांडिंग मनी फ्रॉम हर। डेविड asked his aunt that who was the man and finally she discloses that the man was her husband and her husband was not dead, he was still alive and he always demanded money from her. She requests David not to tell this matter to anyone. David's aunt also calls herself fool and she also calls her absolute fool who was always cheated by this man. On the other hand, David's domestic life was not well. It was very horrible because Dora was not able to manage the home better. Thus, to keep the family better, David wants the birth of a newly born child. Okay? Since David was living with Dora in the cottage where Dora was not having a good health and she was not even active, and David had developed a fear, a scarcity that she will never be, become active as earlier. And unfortunately, Dora suffers a pregnancy and a miscarriage, and she was unable to walk upon her own legs. And David had to carry her up stairs and down stairs. And there is a pet dog, Zip, who barks around them. And David, along with his aunt, leaves to Mr. Wickfield's house, and it is suggested to them by Mr. Mike Ever. And they all meet in a hotel. Okay? There, Mike Ever gives an advice that they must follow to see Traders. And Traders, who is Traders? Traders is David's friend, and whom Mr. Mike Ever has involved for legal help. As per the decision taken, David and his aunt reach Mr. Wickfield's house and they find Mr. Mikeyver working on the desk. And when they want to know that where was Mrs. Wickfield, he replies that she was not well and she was confined to bed. One day David gets a letter from Mr. Mikeyver, and this letter was describing the poor financial situation of his wife. This letter showed that David was begging to meet to discuss the situation, and finally they go and meet Mr. Mikeyver and find out that Mr. Mikeyver was going through a financial crisis because of Uriah, who had cheated him in a business deal. After telling this sorrowful tale, Mr. Mikeyver asked David and Miss Betsey to meet his wife the coming week. And after several months, Mr. Peggotty and David encounter to Martha. That means they meet Martha. And David lost all the desires and expectations regarding discovering Emily or finding Emily. On a certain evening, Mr. Peggotty tells them that they had seen Martha near his lodging. Lodging means living. He was in the house. And what they found? They found Martha crossing out of the house. Then one day Martha comes to Mr. Peggotty and tells not to leave London under any situation. One evening, what happens? Martha runs to fetch Mr. Peggotty. She runs to carry Mr. Peggotty to her home. And she leaves a note for them. And David takes to an apartment and leads up to Emily's room. To everyone was surprised, astonished, because Miss Dartle was present there and she was abusing Emily, and she showed her strong hatred feeling towards Emily. And David didn't want to interfere in this worse matter, but Peggotty did that. And finally Peggotty arrives and takes Emily back to her home. So students, unfortunately, Dora passes away and David goes abroad. And finally, when David goes to the town, he finds a storm in which the ship was wrecked and all the sailors lost their lives, except only one who was wearing a red cap and he was waving his hands for help. David was worried for Ham's well-being. He was scared he was frightened for Ham. And David was also afraid that he would go to the yard and ask the boat builder to take his dinner. David was quite sure that Hams will finally return back from the sea. All of a sudden, finally what happens? Hams comes out from the sea and he was insisting on trying to save his own life. But a large wave carried him and he was killed by this wave. And before he can rescue the sailor and before Ham could seek help or take help from the sailor to save his life, he was killed by this wave. While David was mourning, that means David was grieved on Ham's death. And a fisherman calls David to the shore and David sees the dead body of Steve.